La négation avec les verbes pronominaux. Okay, so we can start right now. And when we talk about la négation in French, normally we are talking about two different parts. The first one is ne, and the second one is pas. Okay? And then, in that video, we will focus on les verbes pronominaux. So we are talking about the verbs that will have this se in front of them at the infinitive form. Okay, so for instance, regarder, to watch, to look, and when you put this se form, well, basically, se regarder, it's to look at oneself. Okay, so it's actually quite interesting. And when we will put these verbs at the negative form, well, they can be a bit tricky. So that's the reason why I thought it might be useful to make a video regarding these verbs. So, let's see, and we will see first le présent, then the futur proche, then le futur simple, and then le passé composé for this first part, okay? So, at the present form, regarder will actually be like je regarde, okay? And then if you put the negative form, it's actually quite simple, je ne, so remember the first part here before the verb and after that pas. Okay, so you've got the negative form here. Je ne regarde pas. Okay, so let's see now when we've got this verb pronominal se regarder, and you can see that when you conjugate it, then you will get je me regarde, and for the negative form, je ne. So now you can see that the first part of the negative form should be here, then you will have me, then regarde, and finally pas. Okay, so je ne me regarde pas. So for the futur proche now, remember the futur proche is somehow a fake future because actually you are using this aller verb to go, so je vais regarder. If you want to translate that directly in English, it's I am going to watch, I am going to look. Okay, so je vais regarder. And in that case, it's quite interesting because you've got two verbs. So remember that when you put the negative form, je ne, okay, so the first part will be before aller and then the second part right after aller. Je ne vais pas regarder. Okay, let's see how it will go with se regarder. So, je vais me regarder. So, I am going to watch at myself or myself. And then, négation, je ne vais pas. So, actually, it does behave the same way. You put ne and pas before the first and after the first verb. Okay, then, me regarder. So, je ne vais pas me regarder. So, let's see now the futur simple, so the real future. And it's actually not that difficult, so you will get je regarderai. Okay, so negative form, je ne regarderai pas. Okay, so it does behave like normally when you get only one verb. And then, se regarder, je me regarderai, je ne. So, exactly the same way, after that, me regarderai pas. Je ne me regarderai pas. Okay? And now, let's see le passé composé. So, normally, le passé composé is quite tricky because it's a compound tense, sorry. So, it will go like, j'ai regardé. And remember that the negative form of le passé composé is quite tricky because you should start, well, first with je, and then you put the negative form here, ne, okay, and then e is going away because you've got the vowel here. So, je n'ai. And then your second part of the negative form is coming right after pas. Pas, and then regarder. Je n'ai pas regardé. Let's see for se regarder now. Je me suis regardé, and then for the negative form, je ne, so first you put your first part of the negative form, then me, suis pas regardé. Okay? Je ne me suis pas regardé. So let's see now how we will construct this negative form of les verbes pronominaux à des imparfaits form, so plus que parfait, conditionnel présent, and then conditionnel passé. So for l'imparfait, then regarder will go like je regardais, and then the negative form, je ne regardais pas. Then se regarder, actually quite simple, you've got only one form or one verb, so je me regardais, je ne me regardais pas. Okay, so remember, as usual, ne first, then you will put me, and then pas at the end. Let's see now for the plus que parfait, remember, so plus que parfait and conditionnel passé, well, they somehow will behave like le passé composé because they are compound tenses as well. Okay, so it will be exactly the same thing. So let's have a look at regarder at plus que parfait. And it goes like that. J'avais regardé. And then for the negative form, je n'avais pas regardé. And for le verbe pronominal se regarder, then you will get je m'étais regardé. Then je ne m'étais pas regardé. Okay, so exactly the same thing. Remember, you will put ne to your first part, then you will keep m'étais together, and after that, you will put your pas. Okay, a common mistake is to put this pas at the end, right here. Okay, so remember, it shouldn't be here, but it should be definitely right after avoir or être in that case. Okay? Conditionnel présent, then it will go like that. Regardez, je regarderai. Okay, negative form, je ne regarderai pas. Forme pronominale se regarder, je me regarderai. And then it will go, je ne me regarderai pas. Okay, basically one verb, so it's not that tricky. You just keep it here. Remember that me should be connected to it, and then before and after. And let's see now le conditionnel passé. So remember, as I said, it's a compound tense, so it will behave exactly as we had le passé composé and then le plus que parfait. So let's see. Regardez. J'aurais regardé. Je n'aurais pas regardé. Okay. And let's see now for se regarder. Je me serais regardé. Je ne me serais pas regardé. Okay, so exactly the same way as we had for the passé composé and le plus que parfait. Okay, remember that actually for the subjonctif, le passé simple, le futur antérieur, so all these tenses that we already covered in the past lessons, well, it will be exactly the same way. Les interjections. Okay, so when we're talking about les interjections, actually, une interjection can also be une onomatopée. We are basically talking about all these little sounds or words that people can produce when they want to express certain feelings. Okay, so and of course, there are differences in all the languages. So we'll see now how we do express la douleur in French. Okay, so here is the translation. And, well, here are the options. The first one will be aïe. The second one, oui. Then you can be, it can be aïe aïe aïe. Okay, so remember, aïe, oui, aïe aïe aïe. When we're talking about le dégoût, so disgust, in that case, we can, well, actually use this beurk, or then pois. Okay, so beurk, pois. Then l'incrédulité. Okay, l'incrédulité. Well, Tu parles would be an option. Then mon œil, it's actually quite funny. My eye, mon œil. Or then oui, sûrement. And this one is quite funny as well because basically it's yes, for sure, yes, of course. But then in that case, of course, you want to say that you don't believe this person. Okay, so whether tu parles, or then mon œil, or then oui, sûrement. Then l'admiration, oh, or then waouh, super. Then trop fort. Of course, in this category, well, it does evolve, and probably there will be some new expressions in the coming months or years. Or but then these ones are the actually the basics that you can find. So oh, wa, super, top, trop fort. Okay, so let's see now. L'indifférence. Bof is a common one. Bof. Then le soulagement. First one would be ouf. And then the second one would be enfin. Okay, so ouf, enfin. And finally, la satisfaction. Très bien. Extra. Super. Parfait, and it's exactly the same as I said previously. So basically, this category evolves all the time. So these ones are the well basics one, and then well the, you can hear some new ones from time to time. Okay, so but then très bien, extra, super, or then parfait. So the important thing when we're talking about les interjections, it's actually it's quite good to know them. Just know exactly according to the context that you are in or the persons you are talking to or talking with, if you can use them or not, because they are not that formal. So if it's a formal context, then maybe it would be better not to use them. L'interrogation. Et les registres de langue. Okay, and more precisely, we will cover la langue soutenue, la langue courante et la langue familière. Okay, so la langue soutenue, la langue courante et la langue familière. Just because, well, in most of the cases, if you want to ask a question, you will have all these options. So whether it's in a formal situation, an everyday situation, the last one, it's spoken and it's really informal. So I would advise you to know it and maybe not to use it. Well, it's up to you, but then be careful. Okay, so we can start right now. And the first question is, qui est présent? And so in that case, you can see that it's a normal way of asking a question. You will start with qui, who, est, is, présent, present here. Okay, so it's, well, a normal question. But then, of course, we can have these two other options, as I said. So the second one here is the more, well, common. So it's an everyday language. So qui est-ce qui est présent? And then the last one, qui c'est qui est présent? Okay, so this one, as I said, it's really spoken and not formal at all. So don't use that if you're not sure about the context or the situation or the persons that you are talking with. Okay, so I'd rather advise you to use the first one or the second one. Okay, so qui est présent? Or then qui est-ce qui est présent? Keep in mind that we tend to use this est-ce que, est-ce qui? Okay, so this is quite oral in that case. Second question, so que fais-tu? Okay, so in that case, what do you do? So basically, we put the verb first and then after that, we will put tu. Okay, so que fais-tu? Let's see how it will go if it's not as official. So it would go like qu'est-ce que tu fais? Okay, so same thing. We tend to use this est-ce que, we add that. Okay, and the last one, tu fais quoi? Okay, so in that case, keep in mind that you should raise your voice at the end just to make clear that it's a question. Okay, then À qui penses-tu? So in that case, it's quite interesting because penser, to think, okay, in that case, to think about someone or something, should be constructed with the preposition à, so it's coming before. À qui penses-tu? Okay, and so if it's less official, then you could, as usual, add this est-ce que, so à qui est-ce que tu penses? Okay, à qui est-ce que tu penses? Okay, and then the less formal, so the spoken way, à qui tu penses, or then tu penses à qui. Okay, so let's see them one more time. Qui est présent? Qui est-ce qui est présent? Qui c'est qui est présent? Then, que fais-tu? And you will get, qu'est-ce que tu fais? Tu fais quoi? À qui penses-tu? À qui est-ce que tu penses? À qui tu penses? Tu penses à qui? So let's continue. And then the next question, it is, de quoi parle-t-il? So parler, to talk, parler de, to talk about, so what is he talking about? De quoi parle-t-il? Okay, so the less formal or the everyday way of saying that is de quoi est-ce qu'il parle? Okay, so you can see one more time that we add this est-ce que thing, and then de quoi il parle? And then il parle de quoi? Okay, one more time, be careful, the last options are really informal. Then avec qui vient-elle? Okay, so venir is to come. Venir avec, it's to come with. Okay, so avec qui vient-elle? So it will be like avec qui est-ce qu'elle vient? So one more time, we add this est-ce que. Okay, and then avec qui elle vient? Elle vient avec qui? Alright. À quoi pense-t-elle? So we thought that we saw that penser is to think. Okay, so in that case, it's not to think about someone but something. So à quoi pense-t-elle? Okay, and it will become à quoi est-ce qu'elle pense? Or then à quoi elle pense à quoi? Okay, so let's see them. And normally, keep in mind that we should, you know, raise you. Our voice at the end because there are questions, so I will raise my voice now. De quoi parle-t-il? De quoi est-ce qu'il parle? De quoi il parle? Il parle de quoi? Avec qui vient-elle? Avec qui est-ce qu'elle vient? Avec qui elle vient? Elle vient avec qui? À quoi pense-t-elle? À quoi est-ce qu'elle pense? À quoi elle pense? Elle pense à quoi? Ok. Few more questions. The first one, comment s'appelle-t-il? Ok, remember, so, what is his name? Comment s'appelle-t-il? So that's the correct way to ask the name of someone. So if you want to actually, well, as usual, make it less formal, then you will have to use this est-ce que, so comment est-ce qu'il s'appelle? And then the spoken way, comment il s'appelle comment? Okay. Où allons-nous? Où est-ce que nous allons? Où nous allons? Nous allons où? Quand viendras-tu? Quand est-ce que tu viendras? Quand tu viendras? Tu viendras quand? Okay, so one more time. Comment s'appelle-t-il? Comment est-ce qu'il s'appelle? Comment il s'appelle? Il s'appelle comment? Où allons-nous? Où est-ce que nous allons? Où nous allons? Nous allons où? Quand viendras-tu? Quand est-ce que tu viendras? Quand tu viendras? Tu viendras quand? La négation, and more precisely, the famous ne, ni, ni. Okay, so it looks a bit strange maybe, but don't worry, it will be quite clear after this video. So normally when we talk about la négation, so the negative form in French, we have two parts, so ne and then pas. Okay, but of course when we talk about ne pas, we are talking about une négation. Okay, and actually it's possible to have de négation as well, and in that case of course the structure will change and we won't use only ne pas, we will use ne, so the first part, then we will use ni, and then ni as well. So let's see how it will work, and we will see so examples avec des verbes, so with verbs, avec des adjectifs, with adjectives, and avec des noms, with nouns or substantives. Okay, so the first one, avec des verbes, so let's see how it will go. So, if we've got a sentence like, il chante, chante is to sing, so he's singing, and in that case, if you want to put the negative form, in that case, it's quite simple, because as usual, we will put the first part, ne, so before the verb, and then you will put the second part, pas, after the verb, so you will get il ne chante pas. Okay, so it's quite simple, but then if you have a sentence like il chante et il danse, okay, so he's singing and he's dancing, in that case, well, whether you will use il ne chante pas et il ne danse pas. So it's actually quite interesting because in that case, and that's normally what people tend to use, okay, you will basically repeat this negative form with et, and, okay, so il ne chante pas et il ne danse pas. Okay, so we've got this other option, and in the case of verbs, actually it's quite interesting because if you use this other option that we saw, ne, ni, okay, in that case it will be quite rare to hear that because in most of the cases that's what we call langue soutenue, so it's really really formal, official, it's not really everyday language, okay, but then it would go like il ne chante ni ne danse, okay, and keep in mind that you don't use the pas at all, okay? Il ne chante ni ne danse. But in most of the cases, well, people will use this option right here. Il ne chante pas et il ne danse pas. And in that case, we're talking about verbs, okay? Because you will see that for les adjectifs, it will be a bit different because, let's see now. Il est grand, okay? Grand is tall. Il est grand, ok, négatif, forme négative, pardon. Il n'est pas grand, ok, so it's quite simple in that case, we just keep the negative form as usual. But then, if we've got il est grand et fort, fort is strong, ok, then in that case, if you want to put the negative form, you will get il n'est, ok, so you will use first this first part of the negative form, ne. Okay, but then as you've got this vowel here, you will drop the E, il n'est. Then you will put your ni before the adjective, the first one, and the second ni before the second adjective. Okay, so you will get il n'est ni grand ni fort. Keep in mind that pas is not here at all. All, okay, so it's a common mistake to somehow try to put pas in the sentence. Pas is not here, okay? Il n'est ni grand ni fort. So let's see now how it will go avec des noms, okay? So the first example, of course, with one word or noun, j'aime le fromage, and then for the negative form, it will go like je n'aime pas le fromage. Okay, so not a problem at all. But then let's see how it will go. J'aime le fromage et le vin rouge. Okay, so fromage is cheese, and then vin rouge is red wine. So it's only for adults, remember that. J'aime le fromage et le vin rouge, and in that case, if you want to put the negative form, then it will go like je n'aime, so the first part of the negative form, ni, so you put it before your word here, le fromage, ni, before the second one, le vin rouge, okay? Je n'aime ni le fromage, ni le vin rouge. Same thing, there is no pas at all, so pas doesn't exist here, okay? So, je n'aime ni le fromage, ni le vin rouge. L'expression de l'intensité. Okay, so l'expression de l'intensité. So clearly we're talking about how to express this a lot thing in concept in English, in French. So it will be, for instance, here we can use des préfixes. Okay, so let's see what kind of prefix we could use. The first one would be hyper, then super, extra, maxi, archi, or then sur. So if we're talking about prefix in that case, it means that you will have to add these little things in front of your word. Okay, so hyper, super, extra, maxi, archi, sur. Alright, so let's see how it could go. Quelques exemples. C'est super bon. Okay, so basically you could say c'est bon, it's good, but then if you want to make it more, even more, in that case you can add this super in front of bon, and you combine it, you get c'est super bon. C'est archi classique. C'est hyper difficile. Okay, c'est super bon, c'est archi classique, c'est hyper difficile. So let's see now if we've got a noun, so un nom. In that case, you can also use énormément de, then it will be followed by your noun. My God, I will manage. Or then it could be beaucoup de, followed by your noun. Okay, let's see a few examples now. Quelques exemples. Il a beaucoup de travail. Il a beaucoup de travail. And then, il y a énormément de neige. Il y a énormément de neige. Okay, so remember, beaucoup de, énormément de, and then your word, travail, neige. If we have un adjectif ou un adverbe, in that case, you can use extrêmement, très, énormément, parfaitement. Okay? Extrêmement, très, énormément, parfaitement. Avec un adjectif ou un adverbe. Quelques exemples. Il voyage très rarement. C'est extrêmement bon. Il voyage très rarement, c'est extrêmement bon. Troisième et dernière catégorie avec un verbe. Verbe plus beaucoup. Verbe plus extrêmement. Verbe plus énormément. Verbe plus beaucoup. Verbe plus extrêmement. Verbe plus énormément. Quelques exemples. Elle travaille beaucoup. Il voyage énormément. Elle travaille beaucoup. Il voyage énormément. Okay, so keep in mind that you will have to put them after your verb. Okay? Et voilà, vous êtes des spécialistes pour l'expression de l'intensité. Merci beaucoup, passez une agréable journée, au revoir et à bientôt. La comparaison parallèle. La comparaison parallèle, so it's actually quite simple. It's a bit difficult to present, so I'll try to be as clear as possible, but normally when we'll cover the examples, you will understand that quite quickly. So basically, la comparaison parallèle, you would like to compare two things that are somehow going in the same direction, so basically, more and more, plus et plus. Okay, or then it could be in the other direction, moins et moins, less and less, or then it could be in the same direction, like that, autant, autant, as much as. Okay, the other possibility would be, of course, like that, okay, and it's plus et moins, or then the last option would be moins et plus. Okay, so let's see exactly what I'm talking about right here. So the first example is plus et plus. Okay, so you can see that I don't pronounce the final S. Plus je travaille, plus je suis fatigué. Okay, so keep in mind that you should start your sentence with plus here. Then you should put this virgule right here, then continue with plus. And basically, what you want to say is, je travaille, I work, je suis fatigué, I am tired. So, the more I work, the more I am tired. And it's quite useful, it's quite simple to make, because have a look, plus, structure, virgule, plus, and then you continue. And of course, if you want to say the same thing but in the other direction, so moins et moins, less and less, well, it will be exactly the same way to construct your sentence. Moins je dors, it's I sleep, so the less I sleep. Moins je suis en forme, I am in a good shape. Okay? Moins je dors, moins je suis en forme. Okay, so it's quite simple. Don't forget here la virgule to make the little separation between the two. And then the other one would be autant, autant. So remember, autant son travail est intéressant. Okay, so son travail, his job, est intéressant, is interesting. Autant ses collègues sont désagréables. Ses collègues, his colleagues, sont désagréables. Well, they're not so nice. And then in that case, well, clearly the same. With this sentence, you want to compare two things. The first one, and you want to put them like you want to compare the two things because they are somehow equally important. So, son travail est intéressant. So his job is interesting. And the second thing is ses collègues sont désagréables. So the structure will be exactly the same. You start with autant. Remember to put here la virgule, and you continue with autant and the structure. Okay? Autant son travail est intéressant, autant ses collègues sont désagréables. So now we'll see what it or how it will go if we've got plus and then moins. Because basically it will change a little bit. In that case, have a look. So we start with plus. Okay? So plus je me couche tard, okay, so coucher, it's to go to bed, and then tard, it's late, okay, so plus je me couche tard, and now you can see that we don't put la virgule, but we put et, okay, and, et here, okay, so plus je me couche tard, et, and then you will continue with your moins, moins, je me lève tôt, okay, se lever is to wake up tôt, early. Plus je me couche tard et moins je me lève tôt. Okay? And basically in the same way, we will construct the structure with moins et plus. Like that, you start with moins. So, moins je mange. Okay? So basically, je mange, it's to eat. Moins je mange et plus j'ai faim. J'ai faim, avoir faim, it's to be hungry. So, plus j'ai faim. Moins je mange et, remember, you should put this et and then continue, plus j'ai faim. La comparaison progressive. And you will see that it's actually quite simple in French. So basically, when we talk about la comparaison progressive, we talk about la progression. So that's the key word. So la progression, it could go like that, or then like that. And you will see that it will be really simple to construct that, because basically in that case you will use this plus et plus, and then here it will be moins et moins. So let's see now how to construct that if we want to combine it with an adjective. Okay, so in that case it will be quite simple. You will need to use this de plus en plus, so basically you make the liaison de plus en plus. Okay, and then here, de moins en moins, but then you make the liaison, de moins en moins. So let's see two examples now. And the first one, il fait de plus en plus chaud. Il fait de moins en moins froid. Okay, so you can see that it's really simple to make it, because basically you've got your adjective here, and just before it, you will have to put this de plus en plus. Okay, or then de moins en moins. All right, so it is really, really simple. Let's see now if you want to combine it with an adverb. Okay, so basically, what a surprise, it's the same. De plus en plus, de moins en moins. Okay, so il vient de plus en plus rarement, and then elle voyage de moins en moins souvent. So it's exactly the same thing. So normally you would have your sentence il vient rarement, so the adverb would come after the verb, just between the two, or then to be more precise, before your adverb you will put this de plus en plus, okay, and then de moins en moins. So let's see now how it will work with un nom. And then in that case, you can see that it's a bit different, because you will have to use this de plus en plus, but then keep in mind that you should put de as well, okay? And then de moins en moins, de. Alright? It will be the only difference between what we saw for an adjective ou an adverb. So let's see how it will go now. Vous avez de plus en plus de livres. Okay, so you can see that you put this de here, and then you will put your words or your noun, livre, chez vous. Okay. Nous avons de moins en moins de problèmes avec nos voisins. Alright, so it's actually the same way, you just put this de plus en plus, but then you need to remember to put de, okay, and then de moins en moins de. So you can see that it's quite simple in French to make this comparison progressive.